Congratulations, Doug. I spent many years attempting to understand the definition of a pastor. Attending many churches in my life, I've come to the conclusion that a pastor in many ways is no different than the parishioner. Along with the obvious education, there is, however, two particular skill sets that must accompany a pastor, and they are integrity and the ability to articulate. My fondest memories of listening to Pastor Doug, either at church or my living room, is that Doug always challenged my intelligence, or the lack of it. I don't run from education. I attend church to learn about the Lord Jesus Christ. And Doug always challenged my ability to comprehend the meaning of Christianity. More often, I believe Doug nurtures those who truly attend to learn. Pastor Doug Smith is a teaching pastor. Difficult to locate that particular approach today, and will be missed by many. Being challenged is how we grow. Pastor Smith did just that. I thank the Lord for Doug as our pastor, and more importantly, my friend. Doug, enjoy. Good and faithful servant. I also heard, by the way, in your retirement, I believe this winter is supposed to be particularly hard. So while you're home, enjoy the snow.
Hey Dad, happy semi-retirement. I just wanted to share my favorite memories of you at Gravel Hill, which is really hard to separate out because you're my dad and my pastor, and so there's lots and lots of memories there. But I have to say my favorite are definitely when you married Nick and I, and of course when you baptized Ian. Those are really special. Congratulations on your semi-retirement. We're really happy for you, and I hope you enjoy it. We love you.
Hi, Pastor Doug and Smith family. I've been trying to figure out how to sum up the last 25 years. You guys came when Nate and I were in the 8th grade, and you've been here for more than half of my life. When you came, you also introduced me to my best and lifelong friend of Judy. Not long after you arrived, you taught our confirmation class and also introduced the Disciple Bible Studies to our church. I believe that these two things helped me set up a firm foundation of my faith. One of the most valuable lessons that you taught us was that it is okay and it's encouraged that we question what we believe and why, what the scripture says, who the author was, what was the context, what was going on around him in the world, and how does that still apply to us today? About 5 years after you guys arrived, you taught us another lesson, and that the church was more than just a building when we lost the building in the fire. You've been here through my highest highs and my lowest lows. You were here for mine and Emily's weddings, Emily's with my rogue 2-year-old Dylan, who wandered right past you in the middle of the sermon, and you patted his little head and sent him on his way. Mine, where the unity candle didn't want to light. You were with us for the baptisms of our boys, and through Evan's diagnosis, treatment, and passing. I'm not sure how I would have made it through without you and the foundation that you helped me build when I was a teenager. As for memories over 25 years, there's been plenty. I think for me, one that stands out is when you and Jeff Arntz rescued me on the roof of the doctor's house in Redbird Mission when I nearly fell off before breakfast. I think you guys thought I was done for the week, but I got back up right after and finished the week strong. For my boys going to daycare, I think they also got a unique experience with you. I know that you performed at least one, if not more, critter funerals because the kids felt comfortable coming to you in a time of need. One of my funniest stories about Evan was when he was in the 3-year-old room with Miss Joan, and she had set up pictures in the courtyard for them to go on a safari. And as the kids were looking out the window to see what wild animals they saw, when it was Evan's turn, he looked across the courtyard and saw the wild animal of Pastor Doug in his office. I want to thank you for helping me find my way through this crazy life. You've been more than just a pastor. Sometimes you were a second dad, but now you're my friend. Through the foundation you helped me develop, I've been able to maintain my faith through the darkest times and been able to step out to become a Sunday school teacher, a youth group leader, and now league team chair. I'm forever grateful for everything that you've done and the friendships that we've created. Thank you and God bless.
buddy.
We love you, Granddad. Granddad. Congratulations.
Congratulations, dog.